Hey, this is Mike. Just got in a 2014 Jeep Grand Cherokee Overland in white, and really exceptional vehicle. And like I said, it just came in. It hasn't been washed or anything. It does have some pollen on it because it is pollen season, and it's just about impossible to get all the pollen off of it. But I'm gonna go ahead and just show it to you so you can see what it looks like. It does have the projector headlights as well as fog lights. It's got the tow hooks there in the front, which are chrome. And it does have a LED accent around here, right there. And I'm gonna go ahead and start it up. Here's the key fob. To start it up, you just push this button twice. All right, I think you can see the LEDs in the video. It looks like they're flashing in the video, but they're not really flashing. So it's pretty cool. Especially at night, you can see those LED accents around there. It's got really cool wheels. They're alloy wheels. I guess they're painted alloy, but they have some shine to them, and kind of like a two-tone silver and gray. And the size is like perfect for this vehicle. Just overall has a really nice look to it. And I'm gonna put the key in my pocket, and I don't need to use it. Actually, I didn't even need to use it. I can, you know, other than a remote start, I can get in the vehicle and use the vehicle without actually taking the key out of my pocket. Now the vehicle's locked. You can see the door handle there and the door lock. I'm just gonna put my hand here on the handle, and it unlocks by itself. It senses the key that's nearby, and also it senses my hand touching the handle. Now I can relock it just by pushing this button. So unlock it like that. You see the inside of the door here. It's got a bottle holder and some pockets there. I do have a real wood grain accent here. You can feel the grains in the wood. You can tell it's real wood. It's not some plastic stuff that they're putting on there. These are perforated seats here. Leather. Does have Overland stitched there in the seat. Really high-end vehicle. Here's the inside of the back door. You can see you have a bottle holder there. Speaker, you still have the wood grain accents here in the back as well. And you do have heated seats in the front and back. Here's the controls here for the back heated seats. You do have a two USB chargers there, as well as a 115 volt AC. It's 150 watts. I mean, you can charge your laptop and stuff like that, but it's not like for a hairdryer or anything like that. You do have the latch system for car seats in here. And these seats do fold down. And there's your cargo area. And you can fold down this side or that side or both. You do have armrests with has cup holders here. Now I'm going to take this key back out of my pocket and open up the back, because it does open up. As it's kind of, you can see the camera lens right there, and you can see that it has a towing package as well as the backup sensors. So here's the back here, really good wide open space for putting stuff in. A lot of headroom here for when this lifts up out of the way. And there's your subwoofer for your sound system. Power supply there. You do have a sunshade. There's a rechargeable flashlight right there. This little pocket holder and a net. And this cargo area has these little rails here, so when you're sliding something in, it doesn't rub against the carpet and wear it out. This lifts up. This is where your spare tire is. And also you have these See if I can do it with one hand. Okay. These little bins that come out. And you can dump them for storage. And you can put them back in there. So pretty handy little bins right there for pretty much anything you want. That closes down and all that stuff out is out of the way. Now, it also has these little, feels like metal ramps here to protect the vehicle as you're loading stuff. Now, in addition to using a key to close the tailgate, I can use also push this button. It's gonna beep at me, and I get out of the way, and it closes down. It does have dual exhaust, and the towing package does have the four-way and seven-way plugs here. So that's pretty good. Four-wheel drive vehicle. Same thing on this side, basically, except for when you put the seats down, both a larger portion of the seat goes down. So that way you can have a passenger there and there's some cargo space. You do have heated side mirrors. Now here's the inside of the driver's door. You do have power folding mirrors as well as power adjustable heated mirrors. So a lot of cool stuff there. Power windows, the door locks are here. You got your wood grain. You have presets for your seats, bottle holder, and little pocket there. Power adjustments for the seat here, as well as lumbar support, which you can adjust it in or out or up and down. It does have automatic headlights. I'm gonna go ahead and hop in. Now, since I used a remote start, I still have to push this button here to turn everything on. So there's that. I'm gonna go ahead and use this little joystick to adjust the steering wheel because it tilts and it telescopes and it's electric. So it has like a little joystick there. Real wood here on the top of the steering wheel here. The rest is leather wrapped and pretty neatly stitched there. Pretty nice looking vehicle, isn't it? Now the steering wheel has lots of controls on, as you can tell. And I'll show you what they do. This is the cruise control settings. You do have paddle shifters here in the back, and right below the paddle shifter is a volume button, which right now I need to put the radio on so I can demonstrate that. So I can adjust the volume here. I can change the stations on this side. And it's just below these paddle shifters. I'm going to turn it down. So that way when your hands are on a steering wheel, you can change the stations, you can adjust the volume, you can paddle shift, all while your hands are right there. And your cruise controls are within reach of your thumb. On this side, we've got a little bit more. I'm going to go start down here. Your voice recognition button is here. You can, since this is a Bluetooth enabled vehicle, you can pair your Bluetooth phone to the system, answer your phone here, make a phone call here, hang up the phone there. Now this okay with the arrows, that corresponds with this screen here in the center of your gauges. Now right now it's set to a digital speedometer. I can push to the left, it turns into a analog style speedometer. But it is actually a screen there, so it's not really a gauge, but that enables a lot of cool stuff. So I'm going to scroll through using these buttons here, scroll through and get some cool information. There's the air pressure for each tire. It's telling me that I'm in full automatic four-wheel drive. There's your range, there's different trips, what radio station I'm on. You can pretty much scroll through and you can adjust a lot of cool stuff there. So I'm going to put it back on the digital speedometer there. There's your regular gauges. Everything's real nice easy to read. On the top left, you see it's 72 degrees outside. On the top right, you see that we're facing southwest, which is your compass. It tells you which direction the vehicle is facing. Right here is your wiper blades and stuff like that. I mean, your wiper controls for your front and rear. I like this stitching that they have here on the dash. Goes all the way around up there. Now here's the Uconnect system. It's like a computer, I guess you can say, a touch screen. Right now it's on the radio. It does have satellite radio, and you have different media devices, SD card, you have a CD, USB, auxiliary inputs. I'll show you where all those are at in a second, just to give you an idea of all the different options as far as, you know, playing sound through here. Like, say, if you have a cell phone that's Bluetooth and you have music on it, you can pair it with the device and you can answer the phone, but you can also play songs through the sound system. And a little bit of a glare from the sun, so hopefully you can see the screen good. I can see it fine with my eyes, but the camera's a little bit glary, I guess you can say. I'm good here to controls. This is where you see the heated and ventilated seats here in the front. You also have the mirror dimmer settings there, heated steering wheel. I'm good to climate control. That's where you control your climate. You do have the normal buttons down here for that, but you have a little bit more options here. Your navigation, you can go to a certain address. You can, you know, set it to where you go to your house, and there's the map right there, so you get an idea of what it looks like. Phone, this is where your phone will be. You can pair several phones, but your phone book and all that will be in here, and this is where you dial. You can also push the voice recognition button and say, you know, call Johnny or whatever, whoever's happens to be in your phone book. And then you talk to them and then all that good stuff without actually holding the phone in your hand and stuff like that. Here's the Uconnect apps. And there's tons of different apps you can use for this vehicle. You can make it a Wi-Fi hotspot. It does have Sirius XM Travel Link, to where you can compare fuel prices, see movie listings, weather maps, stuff like that. Really cool stuff. And if you ever want to turn the screen off, if it's distracting you, you just push this button, turn it off. And you have the time, temperature, inside and outside, and compass and all that stuff there at the top. So there you can tune through the stations. You can also adjust your volume there. Your climate control settings, which are dual zone here. You can turn your parking sensors off in the back in case you know you're going to get close to something. You just push that and it'll stop beeping at you. Eco mode, that pretty much stays on to save you some gas. There's your traction control. You can turn that off if you ever need to. Now here's where your inputs are. You have an auxiliary input there to the left, and then your USB, then your SD card slot, as well as then there's a power supply there. So you could use your SD card as like a little mini hard drive and put a bunch of songs and stuff on it. That closes down. There's your shifter. It is an electronic shifter, and it doesn't like slide like a normal one. So I'm going to go ahead and put it in reverse like that, just so you can see the backup camera. Now you see the lines there. As I'm turning the steering wheel, the lines will adjust and give me an estimated trajectory of the vehicle as it's backing up. And then that way it kind of gives you an idea of where you're headed when you're backing up. And also you can back right up to a trailer hitch and stuff like that. So, and it is a wide angle view, so you can see it, have a really good view of the back of the vehicle. So I'm going to go ahead and put it back in park. You can see it doesn't, the shifter doesn't slide. It's an electronic shifter because it does have A-speed transmission. There's your cup holders. Now here's where the magic happens with the four-wheel drive system. Basically, in automatic setting, you're pretty much good to go in most environments. You have a rock, sand, snow, mud, stuff like that that you can go into. You can also, I can raise and lower the vehicle right here. I'm gonna go ahead and raise it up. It'll flash as it's raising. I can feel it rising a little bit, but I can feel it raising. It's kind of hard to really demonstrate that on a video while I'm in the vehicle, but I just want to let you know that, you know, push the buttons just so you can get an idea that it doesn't make a bunch of noise. It just slowly raises up. The lights will flash until it's reached its designated height, and then the lights will stay lit. So, and I can lower the vehicle right here. There is a slight sound I heard in the back, but it's not very loud at all. I mean, you can really have to strain to hear it. There's your four-wheel drive low. Now, right below it, that's a downhill descent button. That is not for dry pavement. That's not like if you're going to go down the hill and you're going too fast or anything like that. That is for loose gravel and mud, you know, something that's not dry pavement. Loose gravel, mud, anything slippery that you need to go downhill, and you do want to tell the vehicle, hey, I need some help, and you push that button, it'll help you keep control of the vehicle while you're going down on slick surfaces. Now here's your armrest. This lifts up, and this is where your CD player is, and a little cubby hole there. Has like a little tips card brochure. There's your glove compartment, and it is padded just like this little cubby hole here was. It's like a felt material. It does have a auto dim rear view mirror. Place to put your sunglasses is here. You've got a tap light like a flood. There's more of a spot. Same thing on that side. And here's a button to lift up the tailgate there. This little thing here is an infrared for your climate control, infrared sensor. Your garage door controls are here. Now, this is a panoramic sunroof. It goes all the way back to the back seats. So, I'm gonna go ahead and open it up. Let's see, I'm gonna vent it first, push the vent button. Vents like that, so I'm going to close it. Now I'm going to open up the front like that. Now it has a little net that pops up here, I guess to keep bugs and stuff from flying in while you're driving. Go ahead and close that. And then it also has a shade that comes through and covers everything up. Just in case you just don't want the sun on you that day. So it's just like the sunroof not being there. There's probably a tons of stuff that I overlooked, but there's a lot of features in this vehicle. It's really comfortable. It is a high-end luxury vehicle. It's nothing. There's everything about it is quality, and you can just tell by touching it. Everything's soft to the touch. But let's go ahead and look under the hood. There's the 3.6 liter Pentastar engine, and it is, and everything under the hood that's yellow is stuff that you would normally check yourself. If you wanted to. All right, there you are. If you have any questions, my phone number and email address will be in the description. See you next time.